What's up guys, welcome back to Vlogmas Day 24. Ha! 24. Very interesting.
Making our Christmas memories.
So, of course, this is the second last video of my Vlogmas series, and I never thought I'd say this, but I am going to miss this so much. Okay, I know why I'm getting emotional now, because this is not the last video. Tomorrow is the last video. Tomorrow will also be a fun Christmas vlog. I can't wait to share that with you all. Keeping in mind my previous two videos, which have been all about slaying 2021. Today's video also falls under that bracket, and I know that you've been waiting for me to share this with you all. Today's video will be like a sort of plan with me and just sharing how I'm setting up my ink bucket planner. I do believe that many of you have also bought the same planner after watching my review. But even for those who don't have this planner or may not even have any other store-bought planner, and maybe you're doing bullet journaling or something like that, I think this video can still spark in some ideas or give some inspiration to set up your own planners. I was actually hesitant on making this video because I still haven't completed setting up my planner. I haven't even finished deciding on my three big goals and my action plan for those, because I've been so busy with Vlogmas and shooting, editing and uploading every single day for the past 24 days. So yeah, it won't be like a complete setup, but I think I have figured out a lot of things which I would love to share with you all. So yeah, without any further ado, let's take a look at my planner. Okay, so this is my Ink Bucket 2021 planner. I'm sure you all would have seen it by now. I have done an in-depth flip through review of this, so I will link up that video in case you still haven't watched it. So as you can see, I'm yet to fill this out. I'm going to be using one of the Luxor Fine Writer pens. I just recently purchased this set. I will put the link in my description box in case you are interested. Let's go with purple. I'm surprised I did not go with pink. See guys, if I want, my handwriting can be good, okay? I remember from my how to use a planner video, many of you were laughing at my handwriting. I don't feel bad about it, honestly, because it is usually bad because I simply don't have the patience to write neatly and nicely. But if I want to, it can become nice, guys, okay? I'm also going to take a black pen and just write my phone number here in case by any unfortunate means I lose my planner. If it is found by someone on the street, they are more likely to return it to you if you have a contact number here. So I highly suggest you put your contact number as well. People who have goals succeed because they know where they are going. It's that simple. By Earl Nightingale. Honestly, this is simplest way to make a person understand why they need to have goals. Anyways, then you have the yearly view. Not going to do anything with that. So here you can see there's the goodbye 2020 section. I want to fill both these sections only on 30th or 31st of December. Here I'm going to simply summarize all my highlights from last year. And thankfully in my Ink Bucket 2020 planner as well, I have written my highlights, so it'll be much easier for me to just summarize it here. So I'm very excited to do that. So remember how I mentioned I need to figure out my three big goals in my goal setting video? I have a basic idea of my three big goals, but I still need time to think over it. So once I finalize on my big three goals, I will be writing down those three big goals here. Again, it'll be like a summary of how I want my 2021 to look like, including the big three goals. Yes, we have the good old vision board. So yesterday's video, you guys would have seen I was cutting up some pictures, and you might be wondering why they're not here, and that's because I never got the time to stick it. It is a time consuming process, so I think after Vlogmas I will have enough time to arrange and stick all my pictures here. But I do want to share some of the pictures from my vision board. Okay, so I have this picture where you can see like a girl is holding a book reading. She's in a beautiful bathtub with candles and like a cup of coffee, I believe. This picture really screams self-care and self-love to me. I also want to get into the habit of reading, which is why this makes even more sense. And of course, just the idea of relaxing, I feel, is something I really need to embrace next year, since that is something I don't give myself enough time for, to relax. And going with the reading theme, where this girl is just, you know, reading a book, and it's a very cozy vibe. I also want to get fit next year, so I have this meal prep picture, and I have this picture of a girl cooking because I really want to cook more next year onwards. And I have another fitness inspo here: success starts with self-discipline. This is a picture of Korean notes. I am studying Korean. In fact, that has been on a pause since Vlogmas began, so I can't wait to get back to studying Korean. So this is like inspo for that. I also have this quote from from the song Magic Shop by BTS. It says, "You gave me the best of me, so you'll give you the best of you." So BTS dedicated this song to their fans, to ARMY, and I just find that connection so beautiful of BTS and their fans. Like, I don't think it's a fan idol relationship. It's more of like a huge virtual family. It's a beautiful community to be part of. This song somehow reminds me of that. You must be wondering why I've kept it in my vision board, and that's because when I think of my community, when I think of Meg fam, I really get inspired by the relationship that BTS share with their community. So I really want to cultivate that sort of love and mutual respect for my community and vice versa. This song and this picture really encapsulates that meaning for me. This is for Meg fam. I also have some affirmations. Creativity is not a competition. Lovely reminder. I welcome abundance. Create every day. I feel that's going to be like my mantra for next year. I really want to create good content for all of you. Money related affirmation. I have this picture of BTS because these seven men really, really inspire me to be better human beings. Some fashion inspo and just a lot more stuff, which I'm not going to get into. And if you really want to make your very own vision board, make sure you watch the previous video where I've shared all about how you can make your own vision board and how I've manifested a few things from my vision board. Now, even though I did say that I like the categorization of goals, because this is a very popular goal setting method that many successful people actually use and follow, but only later I realized that I am not a fan of this particular goal setting method. I have followed this, I think, for 2 years in the past, and it has never worked for me, only because there just seems to be a lot of goals and I don't think that's practical. Definitely not for me. And if you notice, all of them are in plural. There's health goals, so they're expecting you to put at least 2 goals for each of the categories. That itself is 12 goals, okay? And that is super insane. But then I was thinking, maybe I can use this section to put mini goals, okay? So I did talk about in my goal setting video of having 3 big goals, but I never mentioned about the smaller mini goals that you can have, which I feel would be a great addition, and I could probably jot it down here. So you can see some things that I've written with pencil. That's because I was just trying to brainstorm as to what all I could put in here. I'm still not going to fill in this page right now, but smaller health goals for me could be to make sure that I'm drinking enough water, or maybe counting my steps. Like, those could be like the smaller health goals. For personal goals, I'm thinking of, like, you know, I want to get into the habit of reading, so maybe read 1 book per month. That's what I'm setting for myself. Or maybe even read 2 books a month. I'm still not sure. I'm literally brainstorming here with you all. I do have 3 big goals. One is related to YouTube channel, one is related to fitness, and the third one is related to money. So I feel this is still really useful for me because I do have a lot of mini goals that I could just jot down here. For my top priorities, it will be related to my 3 big goals. For habits to adopt, this will be related to all the mini goals. For example, one of my personal goals is to read at least 1 book a month or 2 books a month. Now, for my habits, I could include reading as one of my habits. So reading for just 15 minutes every day. So that could be one of the habits that I'm trying to adopt this year. Working out 4 times or 5 times a week could be one of my habits to adopt. Cleaning my room every night before going to bed could be one of my habits. Habits to cut, I have brainstormed a bit here. I've written procrastination because no matter how organized and productive I am, I still am a master procrastinator. So I'm going to try my best to cut the habit of procrastination. Then there is unnecessary spending, definitely one of the things I have to stop. Then for new skills to learn, I have written illustration on Procreate, which is on iPad. Camera, I've written camera as a whole because I'm really bad when it comes to like the technical aspect of the gear I use. So I want to get better at that. I also want to definitely include Korean here. Learning a language is a new skill acquired. Do more of, I've written being kind to myself, and I have spoken about that in detail in my self-love video. You might be able to relate to that video. I also want to give more thanks, give more happiness, give more value, just give more and focus on the act of giving rather than the act of receiving. Self-grooming, another thing that I really took for granted this year because of course we're all quarantined, so my self-grooming went for a complete toss. Do less of self-doubting. Oh my god, I wish I could write this in bold. I will write it in bold. Now in the next page we have the goals and the plans. So I'm sure you guys are confused as to, you know, kitne goals hai, like yaha bhi goals hai. How I'm going to work on it is that I am mentioning my big 3 goals in the Hello 2021 section, and then I'm going to mention my mini goals here. And for this section, I'm going to be mentioning my quarterly goals, which I did speak about in my goal setting video. Let's take a hypothetical situation of you wanting to start your own YouTube channel, okay? Your goal for next year is to, let's say, hit 1000 subscribers. Quarter meaning Jan, Feb, March, that's the first quarter. So by March, you should have, let's say, 300 subscribers. So by Jan, Jan you need 100, by Feb you need 200, and by March you need 300. And then of course like that you work it out, and by December you will have 1,000 to 1,200 odd subscribers. So just giving you an example of how you can break your 1 year goals into quarterly goals, this section is definitely going to be very, very handy for me. Okay, coming to the year at a glance page, I thought a lot of how I want to use it. I didn't think there were so many options, but when I searched on Pinterest, wow, there are so many things you can do with this. I will actually link down the blog that I found, but I've decided to use this as a mood tracker because it's just something I would really love to track and see at the end of the year. It's just an overall look at how you felt throughout the year and just be more self-aware like that, because at the end of every day, you are going to ask yourself, how was today? You know, did I feel good? Did I feel bad? Was I upset? Was I angry? Was I super happy? So I feel it's a good self-awareness exercise as well. Now I want to get a bit creative and just put some stickers here and make this colorful. I'm pretty sure I will use stickers in here as well, but since we haven't filled this section properly yet, I'm going to do this properly with stickers. So these are the sticker sheets I'm using right now. It's by the brand Zikoto and it's from Amazon USA. I got it sent from the US. If you have any family or friends there, you can ask them to get this for you, or if it's available to ship in India, I will anyways link it in the description box so you can check it out. But oh my god guys, I did share about this in my, I think, BTS merch haul video. There are also other stickers that I got from there, so make sure you check that video out. Anyways, I am in love with this sticker pack. So I'm using this particular sheet and I'm going to use these three stickers. So I'm going to make a key here for my mood tracker. Okay, so you can see I've stuck these three here. I'm going to take this marker from Luxor, one dash like this. So I'm just going to write here. Okay, so I have my okay day with a dash, a good day with a peak, and a scribble for a bad day. It's just a very simple key for me to understand. I may or may not use different colored pens, but definitely not sketch pens or something, because I'm sure it will bleed into the next page, which I don't want. So I will stick to either different colored gel pens or ball pen. Definitely not like a fine writer or something, which will bleed for sure. It is just birthdays and stuff. I will be filling this up. This section did not exist in my last year's planner, but I did note down all the important birthdays and in an empty page in my previous planner, so thankfully that will come in handy. I will just transfer everything onto here. I'm going to do something that I mentioned in my how to use a planner video for beginners. I will be using sticky notes here, and this is not my normal to-do list. It's just my general miscellaneous brain dump list, okay? Because oftentimes we have a lot of chote smaller tasks or non-urgent tasks that keep sitting on your head. This list is going to help manage my stress as well. Of course, we are going to put this here and have my list ready. Oh, this looks so cute. I can't wait to decorate this. Nothing much to do here. Only once the year begins, I can start filling this out. Hopefully, there will be lots to fill here. Now, beside this, I'm planning to do challenges of the year. They haven't given it as a default section, but I will definitely be making one. I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with this. One idea for a list that I want to make is gift ideas. Like whenever I get some gift ideas to give to any of my friends or family, I can write it down here. So maybe that. There are so many list ideas, guys, on Pinterest, which you can get inspired from. I will link a couple of blogs in my description box. Okay, coming to this section, I am planning to make this into a reading list. One of my mini goals for 2021 is to read more books. So I want to jot down some of the books that I have already bought and haven't had the chance to read, or even reread some of the books. So I want to create a list of the books that I want to read next year. I do have a lot of cute stickers that has to do with book reading and stuff. So I honestly can't wait to decorate all of this properly and share it with you all, mostly on Instagram. Now, the next two pages here, I'm planning to make a big table here, track my social media analytics, which is mainly YouTube and Instagram, how much growth I'm having, watch time, subscriber rate, everything. I think it will be very, very helpful for me. Next page also, I will be using both these pages for tracking my money in terms of earning, saving, investment, budgeting, all of that. Now, every month has that section of, you know, budgeting, but like I said, I just want an yearly look of it as well, which is why I have this section. And now the last few notes pages, I'm going to turn this into my brainstorming page. There are times where, you know, something sparks my interest and I suddenly get some inspiration to make a video on or take a picture of. And most of the times, if we don't write it down, we 100% forget it. So I don't want to do that. So anytime I get any sort of idea, I want to just simply jot this down. And the last page is my rough work. I'm going to go crazy and not worry about how ugly this page looks. Page is sort of me rebelling against that nature of mine. I'm gonna like do whatever I want here, okay? There's no rules. So I've just created this fun rough page for me. And yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. So that was a look at how I'm planning to set up my 2021 planner. I know it wasn't ideal. Like, I wish myself that everything was set and ready and I could just share everything with you all. But trust me, guys, Vlogmas is very time consuming, okay? I don't get any free time, not even kidding. So for me to get that much time to, you know, set my goals, an action plan for quarterly goals, create reading list, habit list, decorate my planner, all of that is super time consuming. So I hope you understand why I couldn't complete everything and just show it to you all. So once Vlogmas is done, I will be focusing fully on actually practicing all that I shared with you all. That's exactly how my process also is going to be like. So yeah, if you want to stay updated with that, make sure you are following me on my Instagram. Either ways, I hope you still enjoyed this video and found it helpful and it gave you ideas on how you can work around with your planners. Please do give this video a big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of my future videos. Also, before I forget, I will be announcing the giveaway winners on my Instagram tonight, just because I can actually pack everything by tomorrow, send it out to the winners before New Year. And yeah, tomorrow is the last day of Vlogmas. I'm feeling very emotional, honestly speaking, but I will keep all the scenty talk for tomorrow's vlog. I will see you tomorrow for the last time in December. Don't worry, I will be back in Jan. But yeah, I will see you all tomorrow for the last day of Vlogmas. Till then, stay happy, positive, and blessed. Bye. Isn't this how it's supposed to be? Making up Christmas memories.